Due to the nature of building a custom computer, you may find compatibility issues with the following parts list. Today I'm here with the latest in my computer build series, focusing on a computer that is aimed at entry-level 1080p gaming performance at the $550 price point. You won't be able to play every game maxed at 1080p, but you will get reasonable performance in any game you throw at it. To start with, we'll be using an Intel Pentium G840. As one of the new Sandy Bridge Pentium chips, you'll find it has solid performance with a dual-core design clocked at 2.8 GHz. In normal gaming, the Pentium G840 outperforms any AMD chip for the price, and is only just behind the Core i3. For $85, this is a great start. Next, we have an ASUS P8 H61 motherboard. This is a fairly basic H61 board, but it has everything you need to get your build up and running for $68. For the graphics card, we'll be using a Sapphire Radeon 6770. This is one of the best price-to-performance GPUs you can buy, and it will run practically any game you throw at it on medium to high settings. With DVI, HDMI, and DisplayPort connectors to support most monitors, this is a great card for only $100 after rebate. Moving on to the RAM, we have a full 8GB of Corsair XMS3 memory clocked at 1333MHz. Having a full 8GB of RAM on a system can be helpful down the road, and for only $24 after rebate, it's hard to pass up. For the hard drive, we have a Western Digital Caviar Blue 500GB drive. 500GB should be more than enough to store lots of games, and as it's a 7200rpm drive, your system should be running nicely for $100. As always, this ASUS DVD burner is optional, but I like to include it as it simplifies Windows installation and lets you use optical media for $20. The case is a Thermaltake V4 Black Edition. For a budget case, you get a lot, including a 120mm blue LED fan and lots of room for expansions for extra drives. Coupled with an extra 120mm fan for better cooling, this will run you $37. For a power supply, we have a Cooler Master Elite 460W supply. 460W is more than enough to power the system, so this will work great for $34. Lastly, we have the operating system, Windows 7 Home Premium 64-bit. If you want to run Linux or already have an operating system ready, you can skip this, but otherwise it will run you a cool $80. So what's the damage? As of November 29, 2011, on Amazon.com, the entire build will run $548.72. For just over $500, you'll get a solid gaming PC capable of handling this year's great games. Do keep in mind that prices are constantly fluctuating, and that it's a custom PC that you can of course feel free to customize to your own liking. If you found this video helpful, be sure to leave a like rating, and if you want to be notified when I post a new video like this, be sure to subscribe.